it is today. But Getright is playing over at Ivy here, and Tabson's right down on the other side. It's not my fault, though, it's the jet lag. I've been to California and back in, like, 3 days, so I have no idea what day it is or what
That's
time zone
we're
in. That's
where you got all that color from.
Yeah, exactly. Hanging out, enjoying Cali.
Muscle Beach, you know, just like getting up into Venice.
Long Beach in the house, yeah.
Long Beach. Dude, yeah. Long Beach is... shipping.
Long? Oh, right.
You know, like, it's not very interesting. Like, oh. I had friends go down to that uni, and I was just like, I feel bad. All right.
Let's see it. Exist failing a bunch of shots, but he's at a fairly safe distance, even though Forrest and Exist both fairly low on health. Penta, they've already pulled a huge upset once tonight in beating Envy. Could they do it again? Grenade is going to land right in Crystal's face, and a follow-up from Exist will shut him down, and Freiburg's here with a headshot. Finally, there's a reply, and it's Tarsin picking up two kills, and then... the bomb not down yet. Forrest and Alu left here, and Alu with a nice headshot on Tarsin is going to bring it back to a 2v2.
Yeah, but Nip, like, why the aggression? The bomb hadn't been planted. They were trying to get off the planet, sure, but now it leaves them in a bit of a tricky spot. Forrest is very low, so it's going to come down to Alu having to do the majority of the work. He doesn't have Kevlar, so he can only take just so much damage. Struxy gets headshot, though, and that's going to start things off. Now Forrest trying to buy time for Alu to make the rounds, and somehow NIP, they managed to recover in this situation. They work together. Forrest acting as bait, basically, allows for Alu to push in and get both kills.
Yeah, pretty good job there. I mean, that initial grenade did 95 damage to Crystal. That's just, you know, that's just painful.
95?
Yeah, in 95. The Exist grenade finished him off for the last 5 damage, but it was 95 in one hit from the grenade.
Yeah. Like,
that's... that's so disheartening. Like, you start the round, you feel like, I can do something in this. Oh, no, I guess not.
I know, no, yeah, exactly. Oh, I can get the bomb plant. No, I
not
can't do that either.
Well, Penta's response, having got the bomb plant, is to buy a couple of smokes here and a pistol here and there, maybe try and see if they could maybe get one more bomb plant in here, but they're obviously going to try and buy it for the third round, which makes some sense.
Yeah, if they can get a second bomb plant, this would actually be really big for them. It gives them options. Literally. Gives them options.
Ah.
And,
I see what you did.
I mean, comes down to whether NIP are going to get caught sleeping at the wheel. I mean, Exist is falling back. There's a couple smokes, though, that could be used to block off exactly lower and have a follow-up as well. Exist changed up his angle, though, and now he's going to be in position to get a bit of a mow down here. A little bit tricky. Holds down mouse one and only gets the one. Alu not able to rotate in fast enough.
And Alu missing all the bullets, essentially. So bomb is going to go down And now they are going to have to get a little bit closer here. Freiburg sneaking in with the FAMAS in hand, making some noise, but Forrest's dead cover is back, and Strux is going to go down. Freiburg doing great work right now. Crystal is on a bit of a flanking mission, but he's already been hurt. He gets the kill and get right anyway, and picks up a UMP. Successful round by any standards here for Penta. Two kills and a bomb plant and a stolen UMP. See if he could do a bit more with it.
Now he's going to play games with Forrest. Forrest isn't going to be silly, though. Absolutely no reason to face. I mean, Alu will be, you know, he's fine being silly, I guess. Usually Forrest is the joker, but I guess Alu had, you know, wanted to show the funny bone, too.
A bit scary because, you know, that UMP, that extra kill there would have meant so much to Crystal, especially with the AWP.
But again, no AWP from him, which is just really odd because he had the money for a glass cannon. So, seems like they want to be a little bit more fleet of foot, Penta, not really rely on the ponderous gun.
Strux setting up for a classic smoke that I think we all know by now, which is going to be followed up by another couple of smokes for the smoke wall here on the A-bomb site. One sneaking in there, and are we going to see the follow-up ones? Yeah, we will. No problem at all there. So creating the full line of smokes, and NIP's response is to try and see if they can jump up and maybe stack on top of it. Forrest, though, hiding in the corner. Going to be the one kill. Could have got more out of it. He's going to get Crystal as well, and look at this triple from Forrest. Clean work in spite of an initial fail. Quad kill to end it with. No damage taken. Penta, I don't know. I mean, the problem with that setup, and, you know, speaking as someone who, like, you know, kind of like try to make it a thing, is that it's become so readable now. It's so, you know, everybody knows. You can see, even without Forrest there, the two people on the A-bomb site were getting ready to boost up on top of each other to just look over the smoke. So there are a lot of ways to counter it. I feel like teams need to sort of evolve from it and say, okay, if everyone has like a standard response, how do we use that response against them?
Oh, especially if you're going to go for the more predictable setup. I mean, teams have been a bit more versatile and found different ways to throw those smokes to give them a few more options, right? Maybe they can wrap to B instead of having to fully commit to A. Oh yeah, you're right. I mean, it was pretty much like one of the first big strats put out there, and now it's kind of seen its use. Still, man advantage here for NIP. Rifles still in hand, and they're trying to make use of that range advantage. Getright takes a bullet to the face, but then Alu gets that wraparound. He manages to take out Tabson, and it's going to be down to Struxy, who did pick up an M4, but he isn't really able to do anything with it. So 4-0 lead now for NIP. Three players survive. It's an ideal situation for them because, well, they're going to have everything they need going into this buy round that Penta are about to go into. And there's the AWP from Crystal.
You know what? So, I mean, right now, Alu and Force doing a pretty good job. But, you know, we were making fun of people in their skins. Mm-hmm. But because of Penta's wins, it means that the odds for this game have been skewed, you know, a little bit. So now all the people lost on Penta are like, okay, we'll win it back by betting big on Penta here, because surely, you know, they take out Envy, they should take out Nip or whatever.
Right.
That's how, like, Better's logic works. That's how you lose a lot of skins in one evening, by, like, letting the outcome of one match immediately affect, like, your decision on all subsequent matches. Man, I remember what this hell was like. And Alan with a good opening and Exist taking down Speedy as well. You know, in hindsight, Tim, I'm kind of glad I got out of it.
I am as well, bro.
You are?
Because when you were, like, sitting there between matches,
crying.
You know, you'd be there just, like, face-palming, looking at your phone because you actually had the app, and I'm just like, oh my god, Anders, like, stop, please.
Yeah. Forrest to pick out Tazanir, and this is a round where, so far, Penta are making literally almost no impact at all. Forrest gonna be picking away Crystal and Strux, shooting Forrest in the back. A petty move, but still works out quite well. Ends up going down to Alu. That's going to be NIP picking up yet another route. Where is that Penta that we saw on Overpass?
Well, they started CT, Anders.
They did. That is, you're right. That's a big difference.
Like, no, I think on T side, they see, I mean, and Train is, Overpass has been around for quite some time now, but the new version of Train, maybe a new team, maybe they haven't put as much work into this map or don't feel quite as comfortable on it. I mean, there could be a number of reasons. NIP in particular, they seem to be fired up tonight as well. They already have one win under their belts. So, I mean, it's not over yet. Far from it. Penta still have a chance. They definitely have a shot. They could be going for the A rush, and, I mean, it does seem like that, at least. They've got four guys gathered up with the bomb, but Alu's in position. He takes out Crystal immediately. There's a gap. There's a gap, Anders, and at this time, it's not a joyous thing. It's definitely a bit of a sad thing for Penta.
Yeah, and just like other subway stations, you have to mind the gap, because, otherwise, you might get. I don't think in Subway you're getting shot, hopefully not, but could still get yourself killed. Mm-hmm. Existing get right here, 2 versus 3. And just ticking past the minute mark, still no bomb being planted. Penta a little bit weary. They want to know where NIP are before they try and go for those plants. And Speedy looking the wrong way gets downed. Tarson would be in a great position if the bomb was down, but he's going to have to come down from his ivory tower up there, and as he does, Exist is looking around and gets him killed. Now Molotov and Tarson making a lot of noise. Exist to finish off every last player, and NIP come out on top anyway. That was a big opportunity for Penta.
Yeah, that's 10-1-1 for all of us. Well, just got to point that out. 9-2-3 for Forrest. Both of those guys just going ham right now. But that was the golden opportunity for Penta. The rush had worked. They'd only suffered minor casualties to Alu, basically, taking advantage of that gap in the smoke towards A main with the AWP. But then they managed to get all the frags right back and get a man advantage. Just the fact that they weren't able to just commit, get that bomb down, get that clock ticking against NIP, it all came back to bite them. First man across, though, and this is the pistol eco coming out from Penta. And, you know, Exist, he knows that. He's got the P90. He's looking for some damage here.
He's ready and loving it. Gonna even put a Molotov in case they were trying to, like, group up to rush him down. That wasn't gonna be a thing. Get right looked like he was almost gonna win that fight, but Forrest there to help out. 7-0 and moving into the 8th round. I mean, I think what we're also witnessing, you're right, they did start on the CT side on Overpass, and I think they might have also just been generally more ready on Overpass, whereas it seems like this time things are a little bit tricky.
Yeah, it seems like they know some basic elements of the map, some of the things that they might have picked up a while ago. For example, the set smokes onto A. But they're just missing the timing. They're missing the timing ever so slightly. And more importantly, those kinds of clutch rounds, like the round that we saw before the last one, those you just can't afford to lose. Like, you absolutely have to win them flat out. And so Crystal, setting himself up in an interesting way, but then just decides to, you know, waste all of that hard work.
Yeah, he's trying to show us some jumping skills there.
This is a jump map, Crystal.
A little bit scary, but he makes enough noise there, Exist, that Tabson decides it's time to charge for the smoke, and Alu is ready for it. I don't think that was necessarily the setup they're going for. Exist just wanted to look over the smoke, but it worked out that way, which is fine.
Yeah, those are those kinds of wonky situations that Penta really need to go their way. Well, now, just Oh, yeah, get right. Huh? Oh. Get right turns. Gets the spray. Yes, he does. And he could get the second one as well. What was this? Crystal, full half second behind his teammate. Way too slow. Get right's going to get that kill for free. And now it's just down to Strugs.
Look at all the blood on the wall. Just like a warning to Strux, if you come down here, really bad things happen. Don't try and do it. If you ever played any kind of like horror game, you know what that's waiting on the other side. And it's going to be Get Right with an AWP close range to take down Strux. Not every day that we get to see that. 8-0. Wow.
Yeah, it used to be actually. Remember when, you know, this was after Get Right, like the NIP had lost and they were looking for a way to get relevant again and find their style. And then
yeah,
it was kind of the tell. You knew that they were tilting if you saw Get Right go for an op.
Because true.
He was like, okay, you know, and he wasn't very effective with it either, you know, so.
I still feel like the worst opping we've ever seen at pro level is probably Scream opping.
Oh, yeah, dude. Legendary. B-Site, Dust 2.
Good
time. I don't know how many shots he missed, but.
It was like 6 or 7 in a row against people who were more or less standing still, so. We're having a really good time then. We can forgive Scream for that, considering how beastly he is. Look at this round, though. Alu gets a refrag, but Pentef switched up their pace. They're a lot quicker this time. They just get in and get the spawn plant, fight for the after plant, and see if they can win it that way. It is a 3v3, and finally, they are punching in the numbers and trying to see if they can get some sprays for the smoke here. They are running low on health. Crystal very nearly dead. Alu going to pick up another kill before he goes down, and Crystal will fall now. It's all on Tabs, and one versus one against Freiburg, and I think Freiburg knows where he is. They both know where each other are, in fact. Nobody has any grenades. Freiburg with a single HE. He's going to get shot down. Tamsin with a triple kill, and Penta finally back in the round here in the game. 8-1. And now they've got to continue for a very long time. Oh, and it's the Get Right Train Auto Sniper.
Yes, exactly. A little bit of a nod. I was just talking to him about this last night, Anders.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. And
you were hanging out with Get Right last night?
Yeah, there was like this Darken thing. It was pretty fun, actually. But Get Right was there, and I'm just like, you know, why don't we see the Get Right Scar 20 anymore? You know, like Train, you're like probably the only player that they literally changed a map for.
Yeah.
Just to counter your one position with the Scar 20. Like, they added all of Brown Halls, that second tier in Brown Halls. That's because Get Right used to sit there with the Scar 20 and shoot everybody's heels as they try to jump by. So, I mean. Yeah, up here, you know, you got that little second tier up there.
Yeah.
They literally put that in because Get Right would just sit in this position and shoot people all day.
Well, maybe he was feeling inspired and wanted to relive the moment.
But apparently, it's not. He wasn't the first one to pull that off. Apparently, it was HMP, an old Swedish player.
Really? I mean, actually, the first time really that I saw the auto type used on Train was actually in the American scene. Like really, really a long time ago. Back when Dynamic was still a team in the early days of CSGO, like some of those Americans did have some pretty good ideas with the auto snipers. I don't know, I don't have like an exact record on it, but I feel like actually the American teams probably did a bit earlier than everyone else. Either way, it is a bit of a push in here. Taps are already low on health, but they are making their way onto the site and exist. He's going to be traded for Tassin, so see if they can actually get this bomb plant down. It is in here, and Freiburg already tacked up a bit. Now look at this, he's just buying time. Strux is going to come in from the high ground and shut down Freiburg. Great teamwork from Penta. That's what we want to see, and a lot more of it. Tabs with a headshot on Forest, as well as Alu and Get Right left now on the NIP side, and should probably just run away from this situation.
Yeah, Get Right's got his Scar 20, though, and he's always going to be itching for a fight. But you're right, these aren't exactly the ideal weapons to go for a retake with, and I'm amazed that Get Right decides to just kind of run in here and YOLO himself. Yeah, point-blank shot, though. That was explosive, and Alu! He looked like he was going to get that second one as well. That was so close. Still, 8-2 the score now. Penta, second round on the board. And, well, they just have so much money in IP. They can still go for a full buy with all the fixins. Alu's got everything he needs.
Well, we shall see. 8-2. Penta barely making it out of that round. NIP digging pretty deep into their bank here to make this round work. Penta taking a while to buy.
Yeah, there were some decisions, actually. I think. No, okay, it's Tossin and Crystal swapping. Shot? Leg shot from Alu. He's still so good. On point and dunks the nade onto Speedy as well, and then goes aggressive. Point blank, misses the shot though, and Strux is there. Brings it back.
That was a headshot as well from Strux. It's making absolutely sure that Alu is dead.
Yeah, no mistakes made. Alu, though, he's going to be kicking himself for missing that follow-up. If you go that aggressive, you cannot miss that shot. And now Crystal's lurked his way through. He takes out Forrest, but Freiberg was there to restore order. Bomb hasn't been committed to a site yet either, so Penta still have some time to play around with.
Freiberg covering a lot of angles right now. Got to be careful up on the train as well. He spots out two people. Tarsen is one of them, and backup is coming in from behind. Freiberg just doing it all on his own here. A grid double kill for him. Triple, in fact. And it's going to be up to Strux now, trapped in a really awkward spot where Exist is about to end this battle right here. Strux is going to go down 9-2, so that's all that Penta got. And the money is just not good enough to sustain further buys here. I don't know. This is a bad position.
Yeah.
I almost wish they'd actually go like 2 AKs, Tech 9 armor, and the rest. Just, I feel like they need a way back in, and that's what they're going to do.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah. I think actually that does make sense here, because it's trained and all that, but like you can't rely on getting like an 11-4 score. Like, you need more than 4 rounds on T side.
Yeah, it's not like old train, I guess.
No, not like that.
It's like 11-3, yeah, or 12-3, yeah. No, doesn't work like that anymore. So let's see if they can actually pull off some magic here. Getright decides to go very aggressive outside of alley, trying to keep him guessing, trying to get that info.
Yeah. Did he hear the AK? I'm not sure if he did. I think maybe he did. Tabson gonna go down here. As well as Tarsen, very low on health. He's gonna get shot down by Alu's second time around. And 3 versus 4, but only 1 AK still in play on Strux.
And the jump down by Crystal. He's gonna get behind that smoke, and he's gonna try and lurk his way through. This comes down to timing. Double scope from Alu. Unscopes, puts the shot, but it goes straight into the train. And all three players here. Freiberg decides to push up all by his lonesome. He's going to get picked off. And now into a 3-on-3. Alu, the point man, but he has a rotation coming through. Forrest is there to back him.
And Geralt coming up from behind could be the key thing that they need. Forrest with a headshot on Speedy now. Crystal and Strux are left, and Crystal going to go down. Strux trapped on the bomb site. And Geralt sees the timing window, and it's going to be picking him off there. So a bit of a chance, but it got stolen.
Yeah, Poseidon strikes out. 10-2, though. And this is a... yeah. And you go for the risky buy. You get the plant, at least. But again, Penta, and you need 10-5. And it's going to have to be that round of eco. It might just go 11-4 here. Best case scenario now for the German roster. So Speedy with the Deeg. We have to see if he can come up with something magical here. It's pretty much... I mean, you need some magical headshots. Freiberg even going so far as to say, I know exactly what you guys are up to. MP9 for him. He wants to farm it up a little bit. And Getright, there's the flash. Gonna be a little bit late, though, and now he gets caught out in the open this time. Speedy there to get the kill.
That was some mad spray by Getright. Hitting absolutely nothing here. And Alu covering the map lines. Freiberg moving a little bit closer with the MP9 here. He's correctly predicted that they don't have armor on the Penta side, but they're still winning this round. 3 versus 2 right now. See if they can get a quick bomb plant. That would definitely help them out. Exist coming in and continuing that spray while strafing in heads. A headshot on Struxy. And now it's down to Crystal and Speedy. 2 versus 2. Alu gets a free kill. And now Speedy going to go down as well. So Heartless NIP stealing away this round for Penta.
Heartbreaking as well for Penta. Man, they could have believed that they were so close to a big round, a upset round that could have really shifted things for them, given them that a real chance at 10-5. Instead, it goes the expected course. We're at 11-2, and the buy is going to come in from Penta. Crystal's got the AWP, and seems like they have success at getting out onto the site. They just are having so much trouble. Perhaps it comes down to communication or feel, but they're having so much trouble holding on to those sites, Penta. That's the real problem here.
I mean, the classic train T side is literally getting onto bomb site quick, getting the bomb down, and then using all these ridiculous angles on the bomb sites to make sure that the CTs can't find you and kill you, and then also have to defuse the bomb. But it feels like what's really happening is they fight their way halfway into a bomb site, then they slow down and wait for a long time, and eventually they try and get a plant in, but then it's probably too late. So, like, that whole slowdown process, it's not working out too well for them.
No, it needs to be eliminated. Not every day that we see a double op play here on the CT train either. Forrest and Alu, they're going to be the ones on it, and already that bomb is rotating into Brown Hall, so it doesn't look like it's going to be the A site this time. It looks like it will be heading over to B. Good timing on the smoke, though, and Exist, he doesn't take that nade to the face. They have no warning now, Penta. Flash goes out behind him as well. Exist in an ideal position, gets 2-3, and that is going to completely shut it down for Penta as Alu is able to chime in with the AWP. Crystal's there to take out Forrest, but this is a calamity. Penta
That was very well played by Exist. I mean, the first guy he saw, the other two he's flashed, and he just had that on pure instinct. That was like the Jedi, you know, play from Exist. It's like,
it's perfect. Imagine if he takes a step to the left and takes that smoke to the face. Like, Penta, no, exact. Ah, somebody's there. Boom, they kill him. They get onto the site. Easy.
Yeah.
Easy peasy. Just the fact that he's one step to the right, Exist, just in front of it. That was perfect play from him. So smart.
Well, the 15th round is coming up, last of the half, and it seems like Penta, they used all their energy defeating Envy, and Exist is born again, we'll see. Doing TSM proud right here, but Speedy shooting him in the back. The Galil is going to come out on top. There's still 91 bullets left here, so not even any reason to reload just yet. Freiburg going to go down. Come on, Speedy. Show us what this Negev is all about.
Well, Forrest is showing what the AWP is about right now. Forrest and Alu. Alu, I mean, basically the two top fraggers for NIP, still alive. Definitely a threat. They bring it back to a 2-on-3 after a good nade. And well, right into the Negev. Smitty is waiting. Alu is down. And now Forrest, he's going to have that angle. Brings out the shot, baits it. Good shoulder peeking here by Smitty, even if he is slow as a Brontosaurus with this Negev.
Look at it. Just the sound, it's ridiculous. He's ready for it, Speedy. Show us what you've got. And there it is. The Negev picking up a couple of kills. Speedy with the triple at the end. That's going to be 12-3. Not too much to celebrate, but still, you got some Negev kills.
Can you remember the last time we saw two Negevs being bought in two different maps?
No, you're right. It's been a while. Are you implying that there's some sort of pattern here? Yeah.
I guess when you go this hard. TSM, well, Device bought back-to-back Negevs earlier on Inferno versus Penta. Like, this must be some kind of, like, joke that's going on amongst the Scandinavians right now, you know? It's just like, well, you know, guys, if we get that far ahead versus Penta, just buy Negevs. It's like, this is the only team that it actually happens to.
I think someone did, like, do a mod or at least, like, change the game files at some point so that you could, like, dual-wield the Negev. So you had, like, one in each hand. Can you imagine how powerful that would be?
Wasn't that the intro to CS? It was a video on YouTube, right, where he's running down mid with the double Negevs, just like, duh.
It's amazing. I hope that could be a fun thing.
Why do you want this game to become COD, Anders? I don't understand.
Just one more negatives, that's all. Oh, running and gunning is Exist. What a fast round here from NIP out into the courtyard. Forest going to be trading kills there. Get Ryan Tarzan going down each, and right now it's 4v4, but NIP on the site with the bomb being put down already, and Exist is lurking in the back lines here. Speedy couldn't prevent the bomb from going down. And now what could they do here? Exist losing the fight, but Forrest is still alive, and Alu's gonna go down for Ebo, kicking him a kill, and Forrest clicking away in the back lines here. He is lethal, one of the best pistol players in the game. And now it's a 1v2. He's thinking there's someone in the smoke defusing, but there's not. Gets a chance to reload, looking for a shot here on Strux as well. He's not gonna win it. Freiburg is back here in an ideal position, jumping on top of the train as well, and Strux, he is out of time. No kit, he can't possibly win this round.
No.
And Freiburg picking up the kill for the triple. I mean, you know, if NIP weren't winning already, they are now.
He's just like, I'm done. At the end, that pose, man.
Yeah.
The ding as well. Bing. It was perfect. It was meant to be. Not much to say about that route apart from just straight up. That's actually kind of like the sort of stuff that made NIP, right? Straight aggression, rely on the aim, and then team play at the end between Forrest and Freiburg. The two of them communicating well, playing off of each other, making sure that it's just impossible for the defuse to go through. I mean, that was like old school textbook NIP, rather.
Yeah, and I mean, it does seem like it is sort of like a return to a previous era for them. So hope that they can continue it, because it is a lot of fun to watch. Tavzan shutting down Get Right, who was being very loud and annoying, and Strux, I think he was trying to line up a headshot then, but didn't quite make it work, and now he's going to be careful. No scope, not working out either. Alu going to win the fight with the MAC-10. 14-3. Wow.
And well, yeah, and you guys can see, no money left for Penta, nothing to work with here. Whereas NIP, of course, they have everything they need. So this might be one of the swiftest maps yet tonight, depending on whether there can be some kind of master play that comes through to save the day here for the German roster. I mean, as far as the standings, well, I mean, this is ideal, though, for NIP. I mean, it was a catastrophe that Envy lost to Penta, but if NIP can get a good, solid win versus Penta, really get that round difference going for them, it'll make a big difference going into the rest of this group stage, considering they are just barely cracking over positive in the round difference.
Yeah, you're right. It's definitely going to help out. Get Right running and gunning with the P90, ridiculously, and hitting a couple of shots of the smoke forest controlling CT spawn, just making an absolute sure Penta can't even get anywhere close here. And even for them to, you know, if they would save like an AK somewhere, anything that they could run away with here, Penta would be a big help. Crystal, he does have a Seuss though.
Yeah, he's waiting for Freiburg.
Make it happen.
Go back Crystal. To Freiburg.
Make it happen.
Oh, yeah, he gets tagged. Or yeah. Did Freiburg already have that 87?
And look at that. Look at that.
Yeah. Good on you, Freiburg. Man deserved it.
That's Seuss. It's just never going to work, is it?
You know, that's the thing, man. If you're just going to sit there and Freiburg buys a Seuss now, what is this? This has got to be a misbuy. Yeah. No? Really? Yeah, there you go. Get rid of it. Don't dirty yourself, Freiburg.
All right. Let's see what it is. Moving into the fourth round, second half here, it is match and map point for NIP, and the round difference is definitely a thing here, so NIP, if they can close it out quick, that would be ideal. Flashbang on its sister's going to get him killed, and in return, Tarzan's going to go down. Alu finding that frag. Freiburg dying. Tabson doing good work back here and spraying and denying the bomb plant as well. Great work.
Excellent stuff. And that's going to put Alu and Forrest in a real dire situation. Well, Forrest gets the peek. He gets the drop on the Strux, and Alu takes out Tabson. Two on two now with more than a minute left. There's plenty of time here for the plays, but Alu comes right into Spitty's waiting's arms. And now it's going to be between Spitty and Crystal, the last two, and Forrest has been spotted as well. Attempts the flick.
Wow.
He's so fast, but he can't quite line it up. He can't quite get those shots. He does succeed in turning that into a 1v1, at least. Rather than facing both guns at the same time, he only faced Spitty, but not able to land the shot that time, Forrest.
You see how tuned in he is, though. Like, you could believe that he could hit one of those shots, and then everything would kind of get a little bit crazy. But, yeah, an interesting attempt, I think, from Forrest. Either way, it's 15-4, and the money is still there for NIP.
Yeah, everything they need. AWP on Alu, who's just been doing, getting so much done with the gun right since the start of this map. And well, now we have to see if he's going to find the angle. He's watching on top of those trains. Get right, though. He's going to get peeked out by Struxy, so there's some information. They know that obviously one man is holding by Alley. And Exist will take out Crystal. That was in Upper Halls, though. That was in Brown Halls over on B site. So that prompts the rotation, as you guys can see. Towson, not really sure if he should be moving from Connector or not.
Still got three people out in this A bomb site, so B is a little bit light on defense and Strux low on health here, 21 on him. A bit of a scary situation right now for Penta. They need to get back in here, and Alu's going to pick up Tabson, and Speedy at least gets a kill in return here, but now Strux and Speedy are both low on health, and hard to see how they can get back in this 2 versus 4.
Yeah, and get right in the back lines as well, just wreaking havoc. Alu will take out Strux, and get right picks up the last frag of this map. Perfect play from NIP to close out Train versus Penta.